why the polar vortex could collapse the global climate. On this channel, we have already discussed the polar vortex and its importance to the global climate. This system of air currents confined to the Earth's poles is vital to balance the planet's climate. Could this be the year the polar vortex spins out of control and causes extreme weather events? What reasons do we have to think so? Although it may not seem like it, the polar vortex located at the North Pole can influence the climate of cities as far away as New York or Los Angeles, California. So even if the polar vortices are hundreds of kilometers from your house, they can be the difference between going out on the street in a light coat and going out with a shovel to remove the snow from the door. But what would happen if these polar vortices got out of control? Could they pose a risk to humanity? Keep watching to find out. The polar vortex is a huge mass of cold, low-pressure air constantly rotating over Earth's polar regions. It is a key atmospheric phenomenon that regulates the global climate and separates the cold temperatures of the Arctic and Antarctica from the more temperate latitudes. In the northern hemisphere, it rotates counterclockwise, while in the southern hemisphere, it rotates clockwise. What would happen if this gigantic whirlpool of air did not exist? Would the Earth have well-defined seasons, or would we live in constant climate chaos? This system is not a simple set of cold winds at the poles. It's a natural barrier that confines Arctic air within its region. But like any barrier, it can be weakened. When the polar vortex is stable, the cold remains trapped in the north, maintaining predictable winters in other parts of the world. However, when it fragments or weakens, the frigid air escapes to lower latitudes, triggering extreme weather events. Can you imagine a tropical city with snow on the streets? Although this may seem implausible, it has happened in places where the winter is usually mild. The relationship of the polar vortex with the jet stream is crucial to understanding its impact. But what is the jet stream? The jet stream is a rapidly rotating current in the upper atmosphere, separating cold air from warm air in the south. The jet stream maintains an orderly and predictable pattern when the polar vortex is strong. However, if the vortex weakens, the jet stream becomes erratic, forming large ripples that allow icy air to enter regions where it shouldn't. Think about this. What if an unexpected winter hits a place without the proper infrastructure for extreme cold? Would we be prepared to survive without heating, with frozen pipes and impassable roads? But it's not all extreme cold. Interestingly, warm air from the equator can move toward the Arctic when the polar vortex weakens, causing unusual warming in the region. This means that the polar vortex not only brings winter storms to temperate locations, but also accelerates the melting of polar ice, which has serious consequences for sea levels. Could this phenomenon be behind today's unpredictable weather? Is it possible that the polar vortex is changing and giving us warning signals? The polar vortex is not an abstract or distant concept, but a key part of our planet's climate gear. It's a system so powerful that it can decide whether a winter will be mild or devastating. But we really need to ask ourselves, will it continue to behave in the same way in the future? Or are we seeing the start of a new climate era? How has the polar vortex influenced different weather events in recent years? While often invisible to the human eye, the polar vortex is the cause of many extreme weather events in recent years. In 2021, for example, its weakening caused a historic cold snap that impacted Europe, Asia, and North America. Madrid, a city accustomed to moderate winters, was paralyzed by Storm Filomena, which left a record snowfall of up to 50 centimeters. Can you imagine living in a city unprepared for massive snowfall, where the streets become ice rinks and mobility wholly stopped? The impact of the polar vortex is not limited to the northern hemisphere. In the southern hemisphere, alterations in the southern polar vortex have led to frigid winters in parts of Australia. At the same time, South Africa has faced torrential rains and droughts at unexpected intervals. How prepared are countries to face extreme weather that defies their historical patterns? The polar vortex has caused unforgettable events in North America. In 2019, a cold snap dubbed the Polar Vortex froze Chicago, bringing temperatures to minus 30 degrees Celsius. In that same year, the northeastern United States faced a bomb cyclone, an explosive storm that dumped heavy snowfall and knocked out power to millions. How would you react if your city was caught between Arctic temperatures and snowstorms, with no electricity or public transport operational? Let us know in the comments. Interestingly, the polar vortex also contributes to heat waves. When it allows cold air to descend to lower latitudes, warm air from the equator can move toward the Arctic, rapidly warming that region and accelerating ice melt. The polar vortex reminds us that the climate does not follow strict rules, and that seemingly local events are manifestations of an interconnected global system. How well do we understand the connections between these extreme events and our way of life? Are we prepared for what could come? Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The polar vortex and its effects in the past. The polar vortex is not only a meteorological phenomenon of the present. Its influence has left its mark on the history of the Earth. From modern winter storms to climate changes that redefined human evolution, their impact exceeds what we imagine. Two events in particular show us how the collapse or alteration of the polar vortex can change the course of history. These are 1. The Texas Storm, February 2021. In February 2021, an Arctic air mass unexpectedly descended to the southern United States, bringing temperatures as low as minus 18 degrees Celsius in Texas, a state accustomed to warm weather. Infrastructure designed to withstand scorching summers collapsed in the face of extreme cold. Pipes froze, roads became impassable, and more than 4 million people were left without electricity or heat for days. Can you imagine being at home without electricity or water as the temperature drops and supplies run out? The polar vortex, weakened by atmospheric circulation anomalies, allowed this frigid air mass to travel thousands of miles south, triggering one of the most severe winter crises in Texas history. More than 240 people died, and the economic losses exceeded $195 billion. If a single event can collapse an entire state, what other future disasters could a polar vortex enhanced by climate change cause? 2. The Younger Dryas Event. About 12,900 years ago, the planet was emerging from the last ice age, when suddenly temperatures dropped dramatically in a matter of decades. The Younger Dryas Event plunged much of the northern hemisphere into a new extreme cold that lasted more than 1,000 years. The leading cause is thought to have been the disruption of ocean currents caused by massive melting Arctic ice, which completely altered atmospheric circulation and collapsed the polar vortex. This sudden change affected human life and may have hastened the demise of some early civilizations. Could something similar happen again? Are we altering the balance of the polar vortex in a way that could lead to a new extreme weather event? The polar vortex is not just a secondary actor in Earth's climate. It is a force capable of transforming entire regions and changing the course of history. If its alteration caused a climate breakdown millennia ago and left millions without electricity in 2021, what awaits us in the short term? Could climate change affect the polar vortex? Climate change is rewriting the rules of atmospheric behavior, and the polar vortex is no exception. One of the most worrying phenomena is Arctic amplification, a process where the Arctic is warming faster than any other region. This uneven warming reduces the temperature difference between the Arctic and mid-latitudes, weakening the polar vortex and making it more prone to fracturing. Have you ever wondered how something happening thousands of miles away could affect your city's climate? An unstable polar vortex can lead to more extreme winters in temperate regions, with cold snaps paralyzing entire cities. At the same time, it could cause opposite patterns, such as warmer winters in the polar regions, which would accelerate the melting of Arctic ice and raise sea levels. When the polar vortex loses stability, the jet stream, that current of air that regulates global weather systems, is also affected. This imbalance can lead to prolonged periods of extreme weather, such as intense droughts in some regions and torrential rains in others. What would this mean for global agriculture? Could we face food crises due to crops lost due to unpredictable weather? In addition, climate change could increase the frequency and intensity of these polar vortex fracture episodes. When extreme events become more common, the current infrastructure might not be enough to withstand the impact. Think about how our cities would react to historic snowfall, massive flooding, or unusually hot summers. Are we designing a resilient future or simply reacting to every disaster? Finally, there are even more troubling questions. If the polar vortex continues to weaken, could we see a close acclimate breakdown possible, pushing the Earth's atmospheric system towards a point of no return? Could the polar vortex collapse the global climate in the future? The polar vortex is a crucial element of Earth's climate system, but its progressive weakening raises unsettling questions about the future. Although a total collapse of the polar vortex is unlikely, its destabilization could trigger deep and prolonged climate changes. Have you ever considered that distant atmospheric phenomena could unleash a domino effect that transforms life around the planet? In the past, we have seen how significant alterations in the polar vortex were associated with abrupt climate changes. Let us remember that the driest event occurred due to the interruption of ocean currents due to the massive melting of the Arctic, which altered atmospheric circulation and ended up completely collapsing the polar vortex. Today, the Arctic amplification, or AA, caused by climate change is warming the Arctic. Could something like the driest event happen again? If something so monumental happened in the past, what makes us think it couldn't be repeated in the future? Today, climate change is putting unprecedented pressure on the polar vortex. The rapid warming of the Arctic, coupled with the loss of sea ice, is weakening this critical system, increasing its instability. The global climate becomes more extreme and unpredictable when the polar vortex fractures. Can you imagine a world where massive snowfall, prolonged droughts, and record-breaking heat waves are the norm rather than the exception? However, the risk is not limited to isolated events. If the polar vortex continues to weaken, it could alter atmospheric patterns in the long term, affecting the circulation of the jet stream and the weather systems that depend on it. This would directly affect agriculture, water resources, and global infrastructure. Are we prepared for a climate that constantly challenges our ability to adapt? The polar vortex is not only one piece of the climate puzzle, it is also one of the main cogs in the Earth system. If we push this system too far to its limit, we could trigger a new global climate instability like we've never seen before. The polar vortex reminds us that Earth's climate is interconnected, fragile, and ever-changing. Its influence is undeniable, from historical events to modern climate crises. But the big question is, are we paying enough attention to these warning signs? What kind of world will future generations inherit if the polar vortex weakens? What can we do today to avoid tomorrow's worst-case scenarios? We want to hear your thoughts in the comments.